Hey, horse people, maybe gun people. Man, out here in the morning, I don't know if you guys can see that moon. And there's a star right out there. I don't know if you can, it's not picking up the star. Let me see if I can point at it. Hang on, I got my coffee cup in my hand. It's right there. Can you guys see that? There's one big old bright star out there. And there's the moon and the horses. Mokey's over there. He's filling his oats this morning. I gotta get the flag hung up. It's been kind of windy, so I haven't had a flag lately. But the sun's coming up here in Texas, man. It's great. It's about, I don't know, 37 degrees, but there's no wind. So it's just really nice out here. Hear a little bit of the traffic noise, but that sun coming up sure is nice looking. Mokey was following me. The rabbit was out here. Oh, got my coffee. It's about 6:30. Set to get a time frame. Already fed the boys. Buddy's stink is pretty much gone for those people. I want to post this on both channels because I'm talking about horsey stuff and gun stuff. So Buddy got skunked a few days ago, so he's been pretty stinky lately. But this morning I smelt my hand after I rubbed him and it didn't stink. So his funk is fading. Mr. T's still social distancing, you could tell. Oh man, what a great looking sunrise. Look at all that mistletoe in that tree. Damn fungus, just killing those trees. I got one batch up here now that I got that new big ladder, making all the firemen jealous. I can get up there. It's just that ladder, because it's a straight ladder. I gotta have branches strong enough to get up there and chop that down. I think I said this on one of my channels. I sprayed, last time I cut down some mistletoe, I sprayed it with a little bleach and water and it didn't come back. It was on those trees over there. Hey, Mokey Cat, what are you doing, boy? What are you doing, little Mokey Cat? So I got one project in the garage that, man, I've been having fun with. It's a pretty cool project. I'll do a video of it. Let me see if I can get in here without losing my camera. I have to keep it outside. Oh, light came on. So, picked up this light at like a garage sale, one of those little places that rent things. And so I've been painting it. I got a little project video where I show the original color and then I painted it. Got it yellow and pretty freaking cool. Let me plug it in. Finally got it working. It was all dirty and not working. The lenses were all, I mean, it looked like crap. So I painted in here with this black. I'll go over that in the other video. Anyway, I'm trying to figure out now how to paint it. Maybe you guys can give me an idea. So it's got these loops, but because it's front heavy, no matter how I hang it, it wants to lean forward straight down. So I can't put a hook. I tried putting these clamps, and even the clamps, it wants to twist. So the actual hanger itself has a clamp on the inside, outside that you screw, but this is like two and three quarter inches. So it's kind of a pain to do it, but I'll have to figure that out in another project. What the hell else have I got going on? I haven't shot my I got to do a video on that one, shooting that. And I already have a video on, I found that on the side of the road. I don't know what the hell I'm going to do with it, but I pulled over. I was like, hey, that looks like good shit. So I got the strap with a hook, which I can usually, you know what? I ought to use that strap for my damn ladder. I just thought of that while I was doing this video. I think these are extension cords. I don't know what the hell they were. They were half on the road, half on the highway. I pulled over and said, hey, what the hell? So I got a little bucket out of the deal. And Moki's over there eating. He's like, Dad, you going back outside? Come on, boy, it's a nice morning. Get your butt out of this garage. You've been roaming all night. You like coming here and eat. Oh, there goes the birdies. I guess the birdies are coming and eat it. I'll throw them some birdie food. There's a little rabbit. That strap, man, I just used a piece of hay string to hang this damn ladder because it is a big, that's bird food. There's that sunrise. Hello, Texas. Man, that video I posted on my horsey channel with the, that little town in Norway with the horses. What a great, cool looking little town. Hi, Mr. Rabbit. Stewie, what are you doing, boy? So I finally got this damn ladder up here. It was a pain in the butt lifting that and hanging that. See if I can get some light on in here. So I'm a little concerned about the wind kind of blowing it and shaking it. So I got those hooks, those double hooks, and I was going to put them straight in the 2x4, and it just, I didn't have the clearance because of the pitch of the roof. So I couldn't get them hung like that, so I had to hang them off a chain. Not a very long chain. Let me set my coffee down so I can zoom in on that. So I put that hook all the way through that 2x4. Then I couldn't, I was just gonna hang that, my plan was to hang that little black hook right over that, but it wouldn't give me the clearance to put it too high. So I had to lower it just enough so it would clear here and clear here because the barn is almost as damn long as the barn. And then I went ahead and wrapped a little safety chain because I was concerned about this sway when the wind gets out here. So the extra chain that I didn't use on that, I wrapped it around there and just put a little quick link on it. On this one, I had enough chain to go all the way around because I don't use this ladder a whole bunch. I just want it out of the way. But I still was a little concerned about the swinging. So I was like, you know what? Let me just put a piece of hay string here. And that'll stop it from going back the other way. So if it does swing, it'll swing in a little bit, but it won't get a lot of swing because this will loosen it. But you know what? That orange strap I got will probably just hook right in there. I can tie that in there and it'll be a quick release. So I'll have to go get that sucker and do that. So those are some of the projects I got going on out here. Him crazy rabbit digging like a maniac. What the hell else is going on? That damn election, people, I'm telling you. The U.S., for you people who watch me that ain't in the U.S., is that rabbit way out there? Well, you don't way out there, boy. You're out in the open. You're going to get picked off. You're going to get picked off, Stewie. You need to get your butt by cover. One of those hawks is going to see you, and you're going to be freaking learning how to fly. So little birdies are eating. I don't know if you can see them. I ain't gonna bother you guys. Keep eating. I'm just walking by. So this damn election, I mean, the stats that they're putting out and the media's hiding is freaking crazy. No president has ever in the history of this country lost a re-election when his poll numbers have gone up. And Trump's poll numbers went up like 20%. And they're saying he's still lost. First time in history. The six counties that Biden needed to win are the only six counties where the Democrat made headway and where he got big numbers. Only in those counties. The statistics and the are just astronomical about how what's the odds of that happening. I mean, there's just so many, all these liberal judges here that are appointed. I mean, look. You can be liberal or you can be conservative or you can be whatever the hell party you want. But I'm telling you, when government starts ignoring the people, tyranny follows very quickly. And this country with this freaking election, to me, should be the start of a second world war or a second revolution here. Because I'm telling you, this is we're officially in a banana republic, this election. And see, I've always said the liberals love blaming others for what they do. They call everyone else racist and they're the biggest racist. They call everyone else sexist, homophobe. They're the biggest sexist. they're just allowed to hate the people they want and call everybody else names if they dislike somebody. And so last election, all they did is say Trump stole it, Trump stole it, Trump stole it. That was a clue that they were going to steal an election because they always want to divert. Just like the cheater always blames the other person for cheating, because that's what they do. And they think everybody thinks that way. So I don't know what's going on with this straight and country, but man, that the stats that I've heard the last few days and the anomalies of just crazy numbers and odds of what happened. Everything fell in. You got Biden who couldn't fill a parking lot, you know, winning astronomical numbers. You've got Trump who was up 800,000 votes when they stopped voting and started cheating, and in the morning he loses. You got like six different districts that after Biden won, every district reported the exact like 60% to 59% for Biden. I mean, that's just crazy that you would have multiple areas reporting the exact same percentage of Biden winning by 1%. That was after he got the big lead after the big cheat. And you know what? The courts, you know, like they said, when you outlaw peaceful protests, you mandate violent revolution. And the people are fed up. And Trump got, like, according to the fake numbers, he got 79 million votes. Biden, who couldn't fill a parking lot, got more votes than Obama. Obama was probably the most popular president around. And Biden, who's freaking Sleepy Joe, molesting children, scandalous, in politics 47 years, hasn't accomplished anything, can barely remember his own name, can't fill a parking lot, suddenly becomes more popular than Obama when it comes to votes. You got districts reporting more people voting than are registered in the district. You got dead people voting. You got people voting multiple times and multiple. Nobody's going to prison. So, you know, when the laws don't apply to anybody or to some people, they don't apply to anybody. And it's just a matter of time before people wake up. And government's nervous. You know, government's nervous when they don't want the people to have firearms. Because they're like, you know what? We're doing some dirty, sneaky, low-down shit. And if the pesky citizens have firearms to fight back, government hates a fair fight. They love to dominate and bully. So, you know, I haven't been covering a whole bunch because there's just so many lies and so much fake news, and it's hard to confirm. But I'm telling you, man, this is... And I always said, you know, I don't know what it'll take for people to finally push back against the government. And I used to say, maybe when they steal an election, people will finally say, that's enough. We need to remove this government per our Constitution. I mean, no other country in the world is allowed to have the rights and freedoms that we have. And we're losing them daily. And we're not very free as it is now because government is just... I hate freaking... You know, most people look forward to Christmas. I hate freaking Christmas because tax season is right there, January. And all the money I've saved all year trying to get ahead and put a little in the bank is immediately wiped out. You know, $3,500 for my property taxes. I got to pay rent on my house to the government or they take it. You know, every month I'm paying $109 to a school district. I got no kids. I don't send anybody. Well, Rick, it takes a village and everybody should. I'm so tired of idiots just... giving government more money to waste. But anyway, I started out as a nice sunrise, and now I knew when I start talking about the election I'd be going off. So I guess time will tell. Mr. T's really eating. They've been really hungry lately.
My goodness, Mr. T, he's a hungry horsey.
All right, well, I think it's supposed to get like, see, it's like 37 this morning, and the high today is like 78 or 79. So I'm going to be sweating later. I'm out here in a sweatshirt with my fingers freezing right now, and I'll be sweating later. So maybe I'll do the horse's feet, and maybe I can figure out how to hang that damn light to where it doesn't twist. It's becoming a big dilemma. You could tell off in the distance they put in those damn windmills. Freaking liberals. Can you see those windmills way out there? I don't know if it's coming out in the camera. Right where the flashing light is right there, there's a windmill right there. And there's like 20 or 30 of them. Just in that area, they're putting out like hundreds. You know, windmills are so freaking great. Without government giving your tax dollars to windmill people, there would be no windmills. Everybody's like, oh, that's great, we're saving the environment. Government is picking winners and losers. When government gets involved, it's always failure. And they must put another one there. There's one right between the house I just saw. I don't remember seeing that one the other night. Right in between those two houses off in the distance, you see a windmill right behind it going up. Ah, well, time to find a state that is still somewhat free because Texas is losing it. All right, well, shit. It's been 16 minutes. My fingers are cold. I'll get in. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys. Like I said, I'll post this on both channels because I'm talking about shit that should involve everybody. People in different states or countries, they probably don't give a shit about America. I mean, I have no idea what goes on in Norway or Sweden or Russia. I mean, I got my own damn government to worry about. I can't be worrying about other people's government, so I'm assuming other people the same way. But, you know, with the media and the lies out there, they probably think America's just a bunch of crazy gun people anyway. I can't believe the number of people that come to my channels from different countries and say, I don't know why you Americans have guns. It's just crazy. I'm like, are you kidding me? Have you not studied history about government once they get the guns, the tyranny? Every communist social state out there, when government has guns, you're nothing but a peasant. You're a victim looking for a place to happen. And yet I always get people out here from other countries saying, why do you have guns? Why do you show guns? Why? Man, I just don't get it. And shit, even in America, just because we have guns, nobody's freaking using them for what it intended, to keep government in check any damn way. So, I mean, I guess it doesn't matter anyway. I'm going to get my flag hung up. Where'd that crazy cat go? He was over here, so... Maybe he's playing with the rabbit. That rabbit and him like to play chase. Well, actually, the rabbit likes to chase Smokey. Smokey just runs. Where'd you go, boy? He's usually sitting up there waiting to get in the house. When I went in to get the camera, he came running in like, let me in. And I said, I'm coming right back out. I don't know where the hell he went. He probably went to his little house. So he's in here eating. Nope. I don't know where that crazy cat went. My guess is he went to his little house over here. Well, I guess that's Texas morning here at the boys ranch. Got the ladder hung. See, that's his little house. He usually goes in his little door right there. Let's see if he's in there. Sometimes he likes to sneak in there and hide from me. Huh, he's not in here. That's amazing. Man, I'm kind of surprised. That cat's usually, I can usually predict where the hell he's at. And he's not out here. Looks like the rabbit's in here. I see a little dark thing. Oh no, that's the pole. See, that rabbit was out there. I don't know where the hell he went. He probably got picked off. Oh, there he goes. Hawk's got him. Bye, Stewie. Rick, you shouldn't do that. Oh, be quiet, big crybabies. I don't know where that pesky rabbit and crazy cat went. I know my damn fingers are cold. The birds are like, dude, get your ass in the house so we can eat this food you put out. All right. All right, I'm going in. We're going to end that there. See, oh, I forgot to do my little test. I'm going to see how that turns out. That's that black rust. What is it? Rust rejuvenator, rust preventer. Whatever, you spray it, it's supposed to stop rust. So I sprayed the, it's Somebody was cracking on my cones. I found that one on the highway the other day. When I see cones, I'm always snagging them because they come in handy, especially if I'm riding horses or doing something where I want to mark off an area, or sometimes if I'm doing out here, when people come in, I want to mark where I need them to go. I'll just say, follow the cones, and I'll leave the gate open. But, so with that rust preventer, you just spray it on, it stops rust. Gate chains are a pain in the butt. Anybody's got horses, you know, chains just always want to rust. They're being handled a lot. I'm always getting moisture on them from moving them. So they rust a lot. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to try that rust. I can't think of the damn word it uses. It's not rejuvenator. It's shit. I don't know. Anyway, so I sprayed this down. It's not black paint. It's actually a coating that's supposed to bond with the rust and stop rusting. So this was all rusty and my chain was rusty. I don't know if the other side's rusty or not because I didn't get it over here. Yeah, so it's not too bad on this side. See, I should have got that area right there. So I sprayed it with that rust preventer and I'm going to see. That's what it is, rust preventer. Rust preventer, I think. And I'm going to see if it stops this rust because this gets used, you know, multiple times a day. I'm rubbing, grabbing, my hands are dirty. I'm messing with the water. I put bleach on the horse's hooves or my water. So I'm always getting chemicals or something on here from handling this. So I sprayed that rust preventer on there. I'm going to see. I put it on the gate over here too. So we'll see if that works. Anyway, my damn hand's cold. Shit. People quit yapping so I can get off this damn camera. Rick, you talk to us. Shut up. We'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.